Hey guys.
Welcome back to Moments with Pastor J.
Hold up, I'm still here.
Oh God.
Pastor J. Today, I'm sitting with my lovely wife, Lena, and we're going to be interviewed by our sons, Jared and Jarrell.
Hi, guys.
Welcome back to Moments with Pastor J. As you can see, I'm sitting here with my lovely wife, and we're going to be interviewed by our sons, Jared and Jarrell.
Stay tuned.
So Jared asked us the questions that we've talked about for the last three weeks. When you think about love, what comes to your mind?
When I think about love, I think of love as being the glue that keeps us together.
All right. How about laughter? We've had some funny moments down through the years. I can remember just episodes where we fell out at our parents' house. We got into arguments, and we've had some good times from laughter. Why is laughter so important?
Laughter keeps you... laughter's good for the soul. So I believe laughter's good for the relationship. So when we laugh, we might get angry, but we come back and laugh about it, it gets us back together.
It helps you to get over it, I'm telling you. Now talk about this. When you think of a lifetime, commitment of lifetime, we've made our vows. We didn't get married to entertain people. We didn't get married because of pressure. But when you think about a lifetime, you know, talk about a lifetime in a relationship.
A lifetime in a relationship is forever. To death do us part. I think about our wedding. That was the funniest moment when Sister Brown said, until separated by death. And so that's a lifetime. Even when you don't want to come home, you still come home because you're committed to that lifetime commitment. And you have to have the stability to want to stay in it for a lifetime.
Mm-hmm. Were there times you didn't want to come home?
We don't want to come home sometimes.
Yeah. Okay then. Or you find out something every day. Then you did a great job. You talked about family, faith, and finances. And when you talk about faith, you talked a little bit about the time when the doctor told you that Jared wasn't going to make it, that he had a hole in his heart, and that he wasn't going to make it. And you and I prayed together, and we made up our mind that we were going to trust God. Talk about faith in a long relationship.
When I talked about faith in a long relationship that we've had like over three decades, that I really believe in my heart that if we put our faith together and pray on something, we should have it. So I really believe that, and I live by that. So I really believe that.
Amen. You know, and then talk about finances, because we've had some good jobs, we've had some bad jobs, there have been times we didn't have any job. The lights, I remember one time I came home, the lights were off, and I thought you were trying to be romantic, and they reached out and touched us. Talk about that, when finances in a relationship.
Well, when I said back in my video, that I do believe that if you bring your finances together, the Lord will bless it once you pray on it and have you to have more. And I believe in your finances, if you come together, you pray together and write out your bills and things and give your tithes and offering, then the Lord will stretch that money for you.
Talk about, when you talk about family, you know, you said something that was profound, that there is no organization or organism greater than the family. And you've shown that together and raising our boys, that family comes first. What do you say about that?
That's true. Family, there's no greater or bigger organization. And if the devil can come in and tear up your family, then it's over. But if you bring the family together, you pray together and believe and come on one accord when you're dealing with your children, that your family will be a success.
Well, here we go. We're getting ready to close this thing out. I believe Jarrell has a few questions for us.
Hello, Mom and Dad. I'm going to be asking you guys some questions about your marriage. And yeah, so let's get into it. Mom, you first. What did you envision your ideal mate to be like?
My ideal mate would be someone that loved the Lord, someone that would be a good provider, a hard worker, and that would be a good example for our children.
Somebody that was beautiful on the inside as well as beautiful on the outside. Someone who had the ability to nurture, take care of our future children. Someone who had their own dreams. Somebody who wanted to be their own person. And so I think I found that.
The next question.
What made me stay this long is the fact that I've enjoyed being with my wife. When I tell you, even through some of our roughest days, we have been the Jerome and Lena team, and I can't wait to see what else is unfolding. So the vows, definitely the fact that my wife takes care of herself and she takes care of us, that's been what has kept me going.
What made you stay this long?
What made me stay this long in my relationship with my husband is the commitment and vows that I made and the stability and praying and wanting to make sure that I keep my vows to death do me part. Yes, I would do it all again because honestly, I have to say, as the song says, that my good days have outweighed the bad days in my relationship. And yes, I would do it all over again.
Do it all over again? I hope the dance never ends. All right, hey, we want to say thank you for watching again, Moments with Pastor Jay. It has been a privilege for Lena and I to share this journey of Unbreakable with you.
I have truly enjoyed sharing this time with you, Pastor Willis. And remember, guys, to like and subscribe Moments with Pastor Willis.
Lena, I look forward to the next 30 years with you. All right, until the next time, God bless you.
God be with you and be safe.